When I talk to kids, even more so than when I talk to adults, I don't try to say big words. I try to speak to them directly. I try to get down to their level. You sort of have to kind of gauge how fearful they are of you and try to make sure that you can make them feel as relaxed as possible. Because I do think a lot of the fears that people get as adults have to do with an experience that they had with a doctor when they were a child, like maybe someone pinned them down to draw blood. And I feel like that is an issue with some people, that they remember that through their lives. So I don't want to ever create that memory with a kid. So I just try to make sure that they're comfortable.
Well, what are you doing here? You're just too cute.
I have this horrible skin condition.
Okay. How old were you when this started? Do you know?
I think about 6 months.
Okay. What happened? What did
she
you did. See?
She had a rash that popped up on her inner thigh.
Okay.
It was about the size of a quarter. It started to spread like all through her legs. She's gotten it, and it's predominantly now worse on her arms.
Okay. All right. Itchy?
Yes, very itchy.
Very itchy, okay. And so is this sort of been just smoldering all the time, or like it gets, does it get better or worse?
It's worse when I wear like polyester or wool, but when it gets better, it's either with lotion or when I take showers, because it clears it up but makes it dry.
Do you like long hot showers or hot baths?
Yes, so, I love hot showers.
Yes. But you feel like the dryness then sort of triggers it, is what you say. So have you seen any doctors for this? Probably when she was really young, you probably wanted to see people.
We've seen quite a few different doctors. We've had different diagnoses from psoriasis to eczema to scabies.
What kind of medications have you been on?
She's been on numerous topical medications, from hydrocortisone creams to oral medications.
What kind of oral medications? Like antibiotics?
Steroids, antibiotics, Omnicef.
Like prednisone, a little bit of prednisone?
She's been on prednisone. She's been on Zyrtec, Singulair, because they thought maybe it was allergy related. And it seems like we go to a doctor, they make a diagnosis, they give us medication, it does nothing. So we go to a different doctor and it's the same thing. And then you kind of just throw your hands up going, where do you go? Right. What do I do?
Okay. Can I take a look? Are you okay with that? Okay, come over. Let's see. So here's some of your rash. And how is this? Is this a good day, bad day, a regular day?
This is a good day.
This
We're probably
really
about a level 4 right here. We can get up to a 10.
Okay, thank goodness you're not a 10. I see. Okay. So are you using anything right now?
No.
Okay. How long have you stopped using things?
About a year.
About a year, a whole year that you're not using anything.
We honestly just gave up.
Okay. Wynter's skin condition presently is in pretty good shape, but this is the nature of this type of skin condition, and they know that it comes back. Wynter could wake up tomorrow and be covered in this really uncomfortable, very itchy, very painful rash. I can see that they've given up, they've lost hope here, and that's really important to reverse here, because this is not something that you can make go away. Consistency, persistence, and understanding is key. But the first thing I need to do is identify the condition.
She's never known a life without this.
My entire life I wore pants and long sleeve shirts because...
You don't want to draw attention to it.
She tries to hide her skin, but...
I get it, I get it. You know why I get it? Because I have this too. I have what you have, yes. And I think what is the issue here is that somebody hasn't taken the time to really explain it to you, so you understand it. I think you have atopic dermatitis is the specific type of eczema. Okay. It is really a lifelong condition, but it does affect you the worst when you're a kid. This can be a really frustrating condition to treat because it's something that kind of comes and goes and it's unpredictable. And you can get thrown all different kinds of medications. It can be really confusing. It can make people lose hope. Atopic dermatitis, or atopic eczema, is a skin condition that we're sort of born with. Like, I had it when I was really bad, when I was young, when I was your age. I didn't want to wear shorts. I wore long sleeve shirts too, because I'm a little darker too, and I would get brown spots where I would scratch. And so I hated like showing my legs and things like that. So I would keep them covered as well. So I get it, I was the same thing. It's a condition where our skin gets dried out more easily. And so when you start to get a little dry, it gets a little itchy. And then once you scratch, then it becomes this cycle of you scratch, the more you scratch, the more it itches, and it
tends to be worse when you're kids. As you grow up, I think two things happen. You sort of outgrow it, your skin gets better, but also you learn how to take care of it.
Yeah.
With a lot of skin condition, the key is to understand what is going on.
Right.
And that helps you to kind of stick with things too and understand what to do in general. So mom, it's really important that you support Wynter with this and really, really have an eye on her because she can't do this by herself. You just want to avoid things that can make you more prone to dryness, right? Try not to take a super long hot shower and try not to use that much soap, actually. Because soap dries you out, especially scented ones. And then the key is I have a tub of moisturizer in the shower with me.
Okay.
So once you take your shower and you dry yourself off and you're still a little damp, that's the time to put moisturizer on. Technically, creams are more moisturizing than lotions.
Okay.
Because lotions are water-based, so they're lighter, but creams are oil-based. So those are the keys. Now, the steroids that you've used in the past, there's different strengths of them, and they will help to clear these up when you have flares. Like if I had a flare right here, like she does right now, mm-hmm. I would put triamcinolone or a little stronger steroid in there for a few days. It'll calm down because this is not something that you can cure. It just more that it dwindles over time. And if you learn how to handle it, you'll be so much better.
Okay.
But it's the education. It's really explaining to you what's going on, that she's not good at creating this regular natural moisturization. And a lot of the products that you might be using are drying her out, maybe unknowingly.
Okay.
Dr. Lee told me I have atopic dermatitis. Dr. Lee has it too, which makes me really excited because then we're twinsies. And she grew out of it, so it makes me want to think that I will also grow out of it, and it makes me feel great.
I know you feel like we're sort of starting over again, mm-hmm. but I do think that we're explaining to you why these things work. And that way you can really help Wynter stay on top of it. We want to be really aware, like you could say, hi, is your eczema better or worse? Did you use your creams or lotions? Or maybe you have to apply it for her or help her apply it.
Thanks.
I know this is really frustrating. Be patient with it and wait it out in many ways. It will get better and she will get better, okay?
Good. I mean, honestly, I've learned a lot more with here than I have with the other doctors. The way you've explained it and broke it down makes it easier to understand and being able to know what to
and
do.
And head it off of the path. And know that you're not doing anything wrong. This is absolutely normal.
With what was given to us today from Dr. Lee, we definitely need to make some changes in the habits that we have. Before we met with Dr. Lee, Wynter's treatment wasn't very consistent, and now knowing that we have to be very diligent about making sure it's applied regularly makes a big deal in her future and in the future of her skin. So now I'm gonna have to do my part too to make sure that it's being applied and applied regularly. That way it clears it up for her.
To sum up, it's really about being able to identify when you can head things off at the pass, right? Okay, sweetie. Eczema and other skin conditions can be really frustrating to treat. Now that I've really taken the time and given them some good knowledge here, they need to take over. They need to work together to really understand the condition, what causes flare-ups, what treatments really help for them, and really work together as a team to make Wynter skin better. I'm gonna have one of my girls bring out some good moisturizers for you that are over the counter.
Okay.
And some good soaps to use too that are mild. If you have questions or you feel like something is flaring, let me know, you know. Can I get a hug? Oh, thank you. From eczema person to eczema person. Thank you. Thank you, Mama.
Thank
nice
you
to
so
meet
much.
You too. Of course,
thank
I hope you. I can help you. And I'm here, okay? I'm just a phone call away, okay? Take care,
thank
okay?
You.
Bye.
I'm very thankful that I met Dr. Lee. Dr. Lee is really kind and a sweetheart, and she's really pretty.
All right, so you ladies are all set. Here's the goodie bag, and then these are their prescriptions.
I feel like I have a lot of work to do and a lot of changes to make.
We're gonna have to work together on keeping up with what you're doing, what's setting it off to make it better, to keep it from getting out of control. So if you notice something that's making it worse, make sure you let me know so we can stay on top of it, okay?